Well, we've got our rights. And I reckon Beard wants to stand up for them anyway.
You're right, Lizzie. But she wouldn't want you to play into Sonia's hands either.
Yes, well, let's change the subject, shall we? Mrs. Powell had some lovely flowers today. They're yours, aren't they? Flowers? Did Dr. Collins send them?
Yes, he did.
Oh.
Beauty, I knew he'd come good. I mean, I knew he wouldn't give up.
Oh, it's wonderful. I feel just as happy as if they were mine. You're very lucky, Petra.
Yeah, well, luck can change. So why don't you stop bludging and fold those sheets?
Exactly what I was about to do.
Get a load of this. You didn't get that at buy-up, did you?
How dare you?
Give it back. Hey, the dog hasn't just got rocks in his head. He's giving them away.
Petra, you're engaged.
So give it back.
Way, I know one someone who can give me a good price on this.
Oh, that's an engagement ring. You can't nick that. You keep out of this ring.
All right, the game's over. Give it back.
Come on, sorry, I was coming here.
No.
I'm glad we've got that settled. You see, I can be very generous, providing we all do as we're told. And we wouldn't want Petra to lose her ring, would we?
Well, the flowers are right. I didn't get a chance to see them.
Gorgeous, in any girl's heart.
Well, that was the idea. Look, can I see Petra tomorrow? Just for a few minutes?
Of course you can. Just get Mrs. Powell to fix it.
Thanks. Well, I better go. Maternity calls. Oh, hi, Wally.
Glad I caught you, Scott. Have you heard the autopsy results?
No.
Well, it's official. Hazel died of morphine poisoning.
Oh,
hell.
No.
They'll probably be asking you a few questions, you know, seeing as you signed the death certificate.
Yeah, look, I can handle that. Judy has some trouble, isn't
it? Yeah, you could say that, but the cops are charging her with Hazel's murder. She's gone missing.
No, that's the worst thing she could do. Surely she knows how much harder that'll make it.
I think she had her reasons, like not wanting to come back to this place.
Yeah, look, I really have to go. Let me know if I can help, okay? Anything.
Sure.
Oh, what a mess. Any idea where she's gone?
I was hoping you weren't going to ask me that question.
Wally, if you'd know, you've got
I just want to give her a chance, damn it.
Her chances are better if she comes back.
Yeah, well, slow down. Look, I know that, and I think Judy knows.
Then why on earth did she go off like that?
Oh, she just wanted a bit of breathing space. I mean, but once she sorts it out, she'll settle down, and I think it's important she does it on
her own. Oh, face facts, Wally. What if the police find her? Where?
My old shack in the hills.
Really before you know. When's the big day?
I don't know. I haven't even told Scott I've accepted yet.
Oh. It'll take ages, Petra. There's the arrangements to make and the wedding dress to get...
Oh, clumsy, aren't you, Mason?
Oh, don't do that.
Dirty, too. A real little pig.
They've just been washed.
Funny. They don't look clean to me. You better do them again.
Oh, stop it, Phyllis. Just leave her alone.
Keep out of this, teacher. You'll lose your spark.
All right, that's enough. Put them back in the washer, Pixie.
Bea would never do anything like that. Bea was fair. You wouldn't do it either if Bea was here.
But she isn't, is she, Birdsworth?
That's right. But never mind, Birdsworth. What we take away with one hand, we give back with the other.
Give what?
Well, one of your old pals will be joining you soon. Judy Bryant. She's wanted for Hazel Kent's murder.
Well, here we are then.
Thanks.
What are we drink to?
After all we've been through, the future.
I'd drink to that.
Well, Mum would drink to anything.
Really good to have you home again.
Oh, yeah, likewise. Well, I hope you don't mind me crashing here.
Of course not. And this isn't just here, this is home.
Right.
You must be starving. Should we eat here or go down to the pub? And you be careful how you answer that.
Well, eating here would be great, but there's one hitch.
Oh, no, don't tell me. She's about your age and the greatest girl in the world.
Yeah, I reckon she could be.
You're a fast worker. When did you say that ship of yours got in?
Oh, sorry, Mum. I know it's first night home and
well,
everything.
Oh, there'll be other nights.
You don't mind, do you? Oh, I knew you'd understand. Hey, mind if I go and unpack?
Of course not.
Oh, you're the greatest. You know that, don't you? Oh, bit of a problem. Couldn't iron a shirt for me, could you?
No luck?
Ah, she's been here. Found this.
Well, do you think we should wait? She might be back.
Oh, I doubt it. The cops could trace her here. She'd know that.
Yes, and she's running out of time. They'll be doing a pretty thorough job. What next? A daughter?
Oh, no. That'd be the last place she'd go. No, she wouldn't want Laurie to get a whiff of this.
Oh, I guess you're right.
Wherever she is, she'll be a mess. Gotcha. Where the hell are you?
Honestly, Pixie, I don't know why you bother. Only a cougar to answer an advertisement like that.
No, you're wrong. Oh, well, just listen to this. Although I haven't been married before, I know the most sacred moment of my life will be when I watch the girl of my dreams walk down the aisle.
Oh, God.
Sounds like a real jerk to me.
Oh, you're wrong. I'd like to give a man like this a wedding he'll remember. Oh, and this one too. Oh, look, I can't make up my mind. I think I'll have to meet them all.
It is a good idea to meet someone before you marry them, Pixie.
Yes, well, what'll I say? Can you help me, please?
Now, just don't forget there's a phony in there somewhere, the reporter.
Oh, look, I'll be careful. I can pick a reporter a mile off. I almost married one once. They're all the same. They have these nasty little eyes and they wear these pencils behind their ears.
All right, Pixie. Now, sort out the ones you want to answer. I'll be right with
you. I've decided on six already. Six.
Are you missing B?
Oh, God, yes, of course. I'm really worried about Jude, too.
I wouldn't worry. Look, the freak's just probably trying to stir up a hornet's nest. You know what she's like.
Yeah, I know all that.
Jude
wouldn't have killed Hayes. They were mates. But if the cops reckon that she did, well, she's going to be in strife anyway, isn't she?
Wow! You look smart.
Yeah, well, you don't get much of a chance to wear anything decent on the ship. Look, Mum, we're just going out to dinner. Wouldn't like to come, would you?
Well, thank you, darling. Yes, yes, I think I will.
Oh, great.
Well, give me a few minutes to tidy up and I'll be right with you.
Yeah, sure.
It's all right, I'm only joking.
I don't mind, really.
Of course you do. I've no intention of going with you. I was young once myself, you know.
Yeah, well, you'll get to see Chen sooner or later. I'll bring her around sometime.
Good. Don't mean to pry, but where did you say you met her?
Well, she came down to look over the ship with a couple of friends before we sailed, and we got talking. Oh, look, she's really nice, Mum. Not like the usual sort of chick that hangs around ships.
So you only saw her once?
Oh, yeah, but we've been riding ever since. And now we've got a chance to really get to know each other.
Well, don't keep the young lady waiting. Go on, go out and enjoy yourself. I'll see you later.
Yeah, bye.
Bye-bye. You're getting old, Mum.
Reg Bull. Pixie Bull. Oh, goodness, that doesn't sound right, does it? I couldn't possibly marry a man with a name like that. It doesn't suit mine. Or perhaps I should have given him to Rosemary.
He might be quite a nice bloke, though, Pix.
What would you know, Birdsworth? I thought booze was your specialty, not blows.
Rotten cow. Can't imagine her with any bloke. She'd bloody freeze him to death.
Just ignore her, Lizzie.
Roland Sampson. Pixie Sampson. Oh, that does have a nice ring to it, doesn't it?
Look, Pixie, I'd say you've got enough here to last a lifetime. How about you starting with that lot?
Well, but I might miss out on the most wonderful man of all creation if I don't read them all.
Well, he might already be there. Come on, start writing or we'll never get through them all.
All right. Well, what'll I say?
We'll let them know what the visiting hours are for a start. Oh, you better give them separate times. You don't want them all showing up at once.
Yeah. And tell them you got good teeth and plenty of wedding dresses.
All right. Well, how's this? My dearest Roland, I received your lovely letter and I think we will make a wonderful couple. I can just imagine walking towards you in the loveliest lace wedding dress, holding a beautiful bouquet of tiny pink rosebuds. When